I'm going to put 6 bay leaves in here. And I actually did an experiment today. This is about 200 milliliters, 200 grams of water. I put in 1% salt. So I put in 2 grams of salt, heated it up to about 180. Then I put some bay leaf, about the same amount, about 6 bay leaves. I think it was 2 grams of bay leaf also. So 1% salt, 1% by weight bay leaf. After about 10 minutes, the aroma really came through, but I really wasn't tasting a lot. But then after about a half hour to an hour, I really could taste just a delicious bay leaf flavor in this water. What I'm getting at, sometimes I've read comments where people are kind of wondering how much does bay leaf add. This much bay leaf in one, you know, virtually about 1 cup of water has great flavor. So normally it just seems like so many recipes, they just put in 1 piece of bay leaf for like a huge stew or stock. And to me, we could use a lot more bay leaf. It goes really well for so many things. Obviously in Madeira, Espetada has a lot of bay leaf. And don't be afraid to add more. I really think, especially if you're Portuguese, you should be planting your own bay leaf tree in your backyard. They're super easy to grow and delicious to have on hand for so many reasons. All right, now I'm going to compare how the fresh bay leaf steeped in water tastes compared to dry. So for this, I only have 1 gram of dry bay leaf. I'll kind of crush that in 100 milligrams of water. That way we're still staying with our same proportions of 1% bay leaf. And there's also 1 gram of salt in there. So again, 100 milliliters of warm water, 1 gram of bay leaf, and 1 gram salt. Give that a stir. And as expected, the dry bay leaf doesn't smell as robust as the fresh. But from what I've read, dry bay leaf should still hold on to a lot of flavor because any plants that grow in dry, arid regions tend to hold on to their oils and flavors more than very tender type of herbs. So again, almost right away, I do get some pleasant aroma. And we'll see if it's like the fresh where I'm gonna taste it in about 5 minutes, see what the flavor's like, then taste it again in about 40 minutes. Okay, it's been about 40 minutes. Similar to with the fresh bay leaf, at 5 minutes, there was not as intense flavor. And after 40 minutes, you definitely get more of the bay leaf. But it is interesting that, and you definitely could tell they're related, the fresh and dry, but the fresh was definitely more vibrant. A lot of times a bay leaf is known to be a little minty, and you get a little bit of that from both. It almost has a more menthol type of flavor that just comes through. It's more vibrant, the fresh. So I definitely could see them both being used, but I probably prefer the fresh a little more, but they're close. I just think the fresh has a wider spectrum of flavors. I thought the fresh had a little more flavor and a little more flavor sooner than the dry bay leaf. Obviously, this isn't double blind, placebo controlled, all that, but that's my opinion of it. And like a lot of dry herbs to fresh herbs, to me, I almost consider them two different things. A lot of times I like the analogy of a sun-dried tomato versus a fresh tomato. You know, they're both good, but they're two different things. And the same thing with a lot of dry herbs to me. And to me, you even could, like, if you wanted a full spectrum of flavors, use some dry herbs and some fresh herbs. They're slightly different. But hope this helps out. I hope what you take from this is definitely use more bay leaf. Because again, you know, 1 gram of bay leaf, which was probably like 4 little leaves, this tastes like a pretty good tea in here. So for my taste, when a soup calls for add 2 bay leaves, to me, there's nothing wrong with adding 6 bay leaves, maybe even up to 12 bay leaves. But again, probably do it in thirds. That way, especially when dealing with the fresh bay leaf, if it seems a little too potent for you, you just don't add in that final third of bay leaf. Hope this helped out. Go cook for someone you love.